Hey guys, what's up? In this tutorial, I'm going to teach you how to fold Manashita, my Indian friend who I took up as a project to fold her portrait. And this is the portrait that I was trying to fold. It didn't really end up looking too much like her, but I think that you'll appreciate that this is a pretty cool looking face anyway. So, all right, ready, set, here goes. All right, so for this portrait of Manashita, I'm going to use a 7-inch square of kami. Begin colored side up and fold diagonally in half. Try to make really precise folds and crease sharply. Now this is a really complex model, so if you're new to folding, I don't recommend this model, but if you're up for the challenge, let's continue. Unfold and fold in half in this direction. Unfold and fold to the crease. Make sure that the edges are flush together so you don't end up with a line in between. Fold this flap over the edge. Unfold and fold to the edge. Unfold and repeat. Unfold and rabbit ear and flatten to the left. Rotate. Fold this flap to here, but we're just going to make two pinch marks. Here and here. Unfold and bring these two pinch marks up to this line, making two more pinch marks. Unfold and bring these two pinch marks up to the line. This time, fold all the way across. Fold this flap so that the edges are flush. And repeat. Unfold the flap and unfold this flap, and we're going to sink. So that means open here and open here. And push the corner in, and we have to pinch on the existing creases. So here, here, and a little tiny crease there. And flatten. And fold the flap over like that, and fold this little flap over. So it's like that, and repeat. Now fold this flap up, not on the two pinch marks, but on the crease that goes all the way across. Turn over and fold this flap up, aligning with this edge. And repeat. Rotate, unfold this flap. And fold the flap so that this edge aligns with this edge. And you also want to align this edge with itself. unfold, and repeat. Unfold and fold the corner to the intersection of the creases. Unfold and fold to the crease. And unfold and fold to the crease one more time. Unfold, and now fold on this crease. And now we're going to make the third eye, the octagon here. And this is really intricate and difficult. So I made a separate tutorial here. Just follow it until you get to the octagon dot. All right, but I'm gonna also show it really small like this. If you wanna just try to follow this, that's okay. So what we're doing is we're folding from here to there, and squash, and unfold, and now do the same thing on the other side. Fold this flap over, aligning with this edge. And repeat. Fold the two flaps together. And fold this flap to the crease. And repeat. Make sure that it comes together in a dot right there. Now, unfold this flap and unfold this flap. Lift up the flap and push inward, flattening on these two creases. So it's like this. Right, make sure that, okay. Make sure it's flattened like that. And these two edges should be perpendicular and these two edges should be perpendicular. Now fold these two points to these two points. And fold the flap down, aligning with this edge. And reverse fold this little triangle. And repeat. And fold this flap up, aligning with the edge behind it. And unfold the flap. And turn over. And we're going to fold this flap in to complete the octagon, but first make a pinch mark right there to make it easier to fold since it's so tiny. Like that, and repeat. Just make a fingernail pinch. Like that. And the octagon is complete. All right. Whew, that was hard. Okay. Now we're going to turn over, And we're going to take this flap and swing it around. So first open here and then lift this up and push on this point, invert this point and this point. And squeeze the corner and fold on these two creases. So it's like this, and flatten it to the side, and flatten it to the other side. And now open here, lift this up, and pinch this fold as a mountain, and fold up like this. So we're folding on this point and this point. Okay, now comes the most challenging step of the whole model. What we're going to do is take this hairline right here and make it slanted. So we're going to rotate the paper on this point, and we want this crease to align with the middle crease. So we're going to rotate it around and squash right here. And now the thing is, we don't want to change right here, but for right now, just squash it. We'll change it for right now so that this edge right here aligns with this edge. So that's what we have so far. And this can squash easily. So again, this crease aligns with this crease. So it's like that. Okay, so we destroyed the eye part. So now what we're going to do is remake this fold right there. And make a little rabbit ear like that and flatten. And that's the step. Okay, now fold this flap up between this point and here. Unfold and fold it inside on the crease. And fold this edge to the edge. And now fold this behind. We're making a hairdo, so it's like this. And just, this is to taste. We're just trying to make a nice curve here. And this can be folded as well. Okay, let's work down here. All right, fold this flap up so that the crease aligns with the crease. So we're folding right on the intersection of the creases. And now fold down so that the fold aligns with this crease. And all right, now we're going to drag this flap up so that this edge touches these two points. Like that. And make the new fold. So again, it was like this, and we just pulled it up, making the new fold here and there. Now fold this flap down so that this edge aligns with this edge. Hold the layers together so that they don't slide. And now bring this flap up. And now we're going to form the mouth. So open here, and we're going to pull out the raw edge and reverse fold it. Estimating 22.5 degrees. So it's like that. And repeat. Make them both at the same time. Okay. And now we're going to drag this up so that it opens the mouth a little bit. Like that. And squash like this, so it creates like a smile. And now we're going to take the raw edge and just curl it like that, and the raw edge here, just shaping the smile to taste. Like that. And same on the other side. Okay, that's pretty good. All right, let's work on the eyes. Let's first put this inside so we can access the eyes easier. All right, fold this down, squash right here. We want it to be a parallelogram, so squash like that, and then squash here so it forms a parallelogram, like that. Again, it was like this, and we just squash like that, and repeat. And now curl that raw edge so that it's round and round, and pinch here and try to just shape it to taste. Like that. We're just kind of drawing with the raw edge. And same sort of thing up here. that. Just kind of squash it to taste. Alright, so there's the eyes. Alright, now we're going to work on the nose. So pull this out, fold this flap down so that this crease aligns with the bottom edge. And fold this flap up so that this edge aligns with itself and we're folding on this point. And fold down like this. And unfold and repeat on the other side. So we're folding down like this. And down again. And unfold, remake this fold, and now fold this flap up, aligning with the bottom of the mouth. Increase that sharply, and now make these two folds, and outside reverse fold, and there we have the nose. Just kidding. Okay, now we're going to flip this over and use this crease that we made to form the nose, like that. And we want it to just kind of shape it to taste, basically. But try to form the nostrils in more of a round shape. So it's like that. And this goes under here. And try to define the nose by just pinching with your fingernail. Just pressing with your fingernail. So it's like that. All right, now we're going to push this paper in, reverse fold it. We're folding this edge onto this edge, and then fold from this corner to wherever it ends up here, and flatten like that, and repeat. So it's like that. Now we're going to take this flap open here and fold it over. So we're folding from here to this point. Okay, so it's like that. And now fold this flap so that this edge goes to here. And repeat. So open here. And we're folding from this point. We're continuing the hairline. And we want the fold to extend to this point. and fold to the edge, like that. And flatten. And you can just kind of fold, make a little squash there so that the hairline aligns well. Like that, it creates a nice curve. All right, and now fold on this edge, like this, and fold from this point to there. So we have that shape, and fold this edge to here, and repeat, and pinch. This is going to be the earring. And open here, and now fold this edge to here, and repeat. So it's like that, and repeat all of that on this side. Okay, now we're going to open here so that it's round. Like this. And yeah, just try to make it like a round earring. And repeat. Careful not to tear the paper here. Okay, and now just basically shape it to taste. Oh, we need to do something here. What we're going to do is take this flap and just pull it out like this. And do a little swivel fold to taste. Just continuing forming the hairline. So something like that. And same thing over here. So go like this and open and swivel fold. So it's like that. And now fold this corner in so that we're rounding the chin. And curve so it's like a mask. Okay, this is on top. This little flap right here, this corner here, can go underneath. And just shape it. And same over here, hide this thing underneath. This part comes on top, and the eyes hold the dot down. So it's like that, and continue rounding it. And now just kind of make a little soft fold to make the chin a little bit sharper. Like that. We're just bending right here. And just a little bit more rounding to taste. Okay, and for the eyebrows, just suggest eyebrows with pinches on this flap. And repeat. And there it is. All right. Hope you guys were able to fold that, and let me know what you think.